Okay, so I wanted to ask Melanie, and I wanted to film Melanie because I feel like there's a gap between what we deliver and what gorgeous girls like Melanie get. And so I chose Melanie because when she told me how frustrated she was, I just thought, we can't have this. This is wrong. And so filming this will hopefully make you realise that we've still got work to do as an industry. So tell me, Mel, why do you tie your hair up? Every time I see you, you're beautifully dressed. You've always got your makeup on and you've got your hair tied up. And I can see, as a hairdresser knows, I can spot a curl at 10 paces. So it's curly, yes?
Yes.
And you tie it up.
Yes, Lisa, my hair is curly. I actually did attempt to cut it into a new style about 4 months ago. And I was so disappointed and I was so frustrated because I just couldn't manage it at home that within about a week, I put it back up. And as I said, it's been four months. It's been up every day ever since. Yeah. And I don't even have any inclination to go back to the hairdresser to get it cut again because what's the point?
Okay, so when was the last time someone said you've got lovely hair, Mel?
Years, Lisa, absolutely years. Yeah. I feel like the years that I used to have beautiful hair and I used to feel beautiful are gone. They're over.
It's terrible. So 10 years?
Yeah, I'd say about 10 years since I've felt good. And it affects me greatly. Like I catch myself in the mirror and I just think, oh my God, it's so jarring. I just think, oh, it's not me. I just don't feel feminine. I don't feel attractive. And yeah, I'm a bit lost. I'm lost.
Okay, and that's why I wanted to do you as a case study. Now, this might come as a surprise to you, but this wild head of hair, I left it straight. I straightened it with an iron till I was 36. I tied it up for a long time. And when I was 36, I left it out because I was on holidays and I couldn't get the curls. I couldn't use the irons. I was in America. And people started to compliment me on my hair. So I thought, okay. But I was a bit like you. When I left it out, I didn't like it. I felt like it was sort of big at the bottom.
Yes.
And I had this pinhead, and I'm a bit like a little brat style. I've got this big head of hair, and I'm only a little person. So, and I heard you say before, I don't feel that your head shape matches your body.
No, I've got this little face and this bigger body. And
your hair doesn't match.
And my hair doesn't match. But when I have my hair out, it ends up in this frizz of this triangular frizz with, you know, the flat top and the...
Yeah.
It's just, and it's uncomfortable. It feels uncomfortable.
Yeah, so we're going to fix that. So my challenge is to take you somewhere who I love. I think she's just awesome. She lives and breathes hairdressing and she just cuts it all like you would cut a hedge like that.
Fantastic. Bring it on. I just can't wait. I'm so excited. I just can't wait.
So we're going to look at the whole lot. Tomorrow we'll start with a haircut, but I think there's probably a better colour for you too. Like your eyes are beautiful and I just don't get showcased. The other thing is I probably wouldn't go a day without someone telling me I love your hair.
Yeah.
And I just take it for granted. And I wasn't until I was with a girlfriend and she said, and I said, oh, thanks, or something, is your hair natural? And I say, yes, well, it's not. I colour it and I tong the curls. So it's not really natural. Natural's wash and dry and I'd be great. So I just say yes because it's easier. But then I feel like I'm always explaining. And I just take it for granted that people say, I love your hair. And this is 2 days ago I washed it. So imagine if you could wash your hair in the last couple of days and people would compliment
Lisa,
you on your hair.
I could not imagine. I couldn't imagine people complimenting me. I couldn't imagine being able to get out of bed and wear my hair again and it look fabulous.
I always say, you know Bob the Builder?
Yeah.
Well, I was his sister. Bob's sister and I can fix this, I promise you. Might take a couple of tweaks, but if you're honest and you tell me what you're really feeling, we'll fix this till the end, all right?
You know I'm a hard case though.
No, it's not a hard case. You're a typical case. It's really sad. I promise I'll fix it.
Great.
It's a deal.
Let's go.
So I'm here today because I want to share with Mel and Mel what's missing in her life. She looks ashamed of her hair when she ties it. So I'm here at Hair Wedding Song of India. It's my choice. It's just my choice. So this is the before, this is Mel, and she's one of the most gorgeous girls I know, and have a look at her eyes, but she hasn't been looked after herself for a very long time, so that's why I come in. I don't believe that's right. I think there's a gap between what the hairdresser wears and what the consumer wears. So girls had some haircuts with no care at home whatsoever, which is absolutely wrong. So, this is how Mel normally wears it. Like that, because she's absolutely given up rubbish. So, tell just a few words, your own words, Mel. What is it that you feel? Why do you feel like your hair lets you down?
I just can't get a style. I can't get anyone to work out a style that works for my small face and with my curls. It's just
disastrous.
It's just hard work.
And the thing that I find really interesting is you lost all your hair once. How long ago?
It was about 4 years ago. 4 years ago.
Yeah. I'm sorry, mate.
I've only grown it back. So I've only had hair again for the past 2 years, and it's taken 2 years to grow back. But it's grown back differently. So I used to have straight hair. Now it's all curly. And I mean,
I don't know what to do with it. Like, how many women would love to have curly hair? But I don't know. I thought it was the first time I was 36. And when they go past someone and say to me, It's another story. Today we're talking about the cut. Right, so we're going to stop now. And Tina, who won't be in the screen because she's shy, is going to be here. And I'm just going to film around the salon and out and put it together. So this is the before. You know, all this is the before. Wait a minute. Okay, so here we are now. I
love it. Amazing.
Do you feel better?
The curl's really nice and the shape's really nice. The colour's beautiful. I feel like a better me. I'm feeling much more comfortable.
I think it'll take a little bit of time, to be honest. It will take a little bit of time because managing curls is a whole new ball game. When you work it out, like your qualities, what your techniques, you can't get back. I don't know how long it'll be. When someone says, I love your hair, that was
okay. Yeah.
Right. There's a difference between a good salon and a good shop.
Yeah, I think that's right.
And there's about 15 million hairdressers in the country. It's like a nest. And this girl here, come over here. That's
just magic.
Why do you do what you do?
Because I love what I do. I love it simple. Love what you do and you think about it. Simple as that.
Thank you.
Thank you, Tina.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.